Welcome to the second installment of our Kitchen Rituals Fall Feast Special. If you haven't seen our appetizer video yet, please go and watch it. Gianna made a delicious pumpkin hummus and you just can't miss it. As for me, my name is Jean. I'm an intern at Food Period. If you've watched our channel before, you may recognize me from our pesto pasta video a while back. And I'm here again today. If you haven't heard of Food Period, we make nutritionist-backed period improvement products. Check out the links in our description box down below if you want to learn more about us. Now today I will be making a veggie pot pie with a seedy, garlicky, herby compound butter, and I'll be making it using our phase 2 moon seeds. Again, this is a blend of sunflower and sesame seeds. This veggie pot pie is the perfect comfort food. It's vegetarian and it's super simple to make, but it's still impressive enough to bring to a fun potluck or if you're just enjoying a meal with your close family. I'm really excited. Let's get started. For the compound butter, you will need 1 stick or 1/2 cup of softened butter, 1 clove of minced garlic, 1 tablespoon of fresh, finely chopped herbs, and of course, 1/2 cup of ground phase 2 moon seeds. If you don't know what moon seeds are, they're a blend of raw organic seeds that are hormone supportive and can improve your menstrual health. Today, I'm using the phase 2 blend of sesame and sunflower seeds because I think it'll pair well with the flavors we have going on today. On to the pot pie. It takes a bit of prep work, but I promise it's really easy to make. For vegetables, you'll need 1/2 yellow onion, 2 medium carrots, and 1 small russet potato, all peeled and diced, 1 cup of frozen peas, and 12 ounces of sliced mushrooms. I'm using some baby bellas that I already had on hand. There are 2 points I would like to make about these vegetables. First, yes, you may substitute everything with frozen vegetables because I know sometimes you just can't be bothered to peel and chop everything. And second, I'm kind of giving you estimates on these measurements because honestly, I don't know how much I actually put in here. So just do whatever feels right. Moving on, you will also need 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour, 1 cup of mushroom or veggie stock, or any soup base of your choice, honestly. I'm using dashi, but if you don't need it to be entirely vegetarian, feel free to use chicken or beef broth. Next, 1 cup of milk of your choice. Next, you'll need 1 tablespoon of distilled white vinegar, salt and pepper to taste, a sheet of puff pastry, and finally, 1 large egg for egg wash. Let's start cooking, shall we? Now, before you start anything, preheat your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Don't forget to do this. I forgot once and it sucked. Next, for the compound butter. In a bowl, combine the softened butter, minced garlic, freshly chopped herbs, and ground phase 2 moon seeds. Mix that until well combined. It seems that the whisk was a bad idea. I'm struggling. Don't do this. Please use a spatula. See? Much better with a spatula. Anyway, you can keep it in a bowl and spoon to serve, but for easy portioning, I'm going to place it in plastic wrap and roll it into a log shape. And refrigerate this for at least 1 hour or overnight. Now this butter log is enough for 8 full days of seed sinking, so don't think you have to eat it all at once. I strongly advise against that. Now we can get started on our pot pie. This recipe is also good for 8 servings. In a heavy bottom saucepan or Dutch oven, add a bit of butter or oil and onions and carrots. Cook until the onions are translucent and carrots are soft. Here's where I realized I made a little mistake. The pot I'm using is way too small, so use a bigger cooking vessel and don't try to power through it like I did for the remainder of this video. Next, add mushrooms and potatoes, season with salt and pepper, and stir to coat. Keep cooking, stirring rarely until the mushrooms shrink and let off water. Then add 1/2 of the flour over the vegetables, stir to coat, and repeat. Add broth and milk, stirring constantly until the mixture is smooth. And bring to a simmer and keep cooking until the mixture is slightly thickened. Next, you'll add the frozen peas and remove them from the heat to stir. The residual heat will take care of the frozen peas. Next, add your vinegar and stir well. And at this point, you can season with more salt and pepper to taste. Now, be careful here. Empty the filling into a baking dish. If you don't want to make such a large thing of pot pie though, you can use small ramekins to make individual pies. Drape your puff pastry sheet over the filling and cut off excess dough. And cut slits in the dough for ventilation. You don't want your pie to explode in the oven. Actually, I'm not sure if it would explode, but I don't want to risk that. If you guys do it, let me know. Actually, don't do that. Please don't do that. Anyway, beat your egg and brush the dough with egg wash. Place the dish on a baking sheet for easy handling and bake in your screaming hot oven for 25 to 30 minutes. As you wait, you can take a quick snack break and clean up the mess you made in the kitchen. You'll know your pie is done when you open the oven and have this reaction.
Ooh.
The mixture should be bubbling and the crust should be a glorious golden brown. Here's some beautiful crusty ASMR for you. It is time to assemble your plate. Cut out a piece of pie and serve with a pat of butter while it's still warm. Man, I really have an issue with using the wrong tool. Please cut your pie and butter with a proper knife and serve with a spoon instead of a flat spatula. Mix in your pat of butter for some buttery, seedy, garlicky, herby goodness. Look at her, she's glorious. And okay, yes, I know you might be thinking that that's kind of a lot of butter, but okay, it's the fall feast and I feel like consuming a bit of butter during this time of year is perfectly okay. Dig in and enjoy your glorious pot pie and seedy compound butter. I made the mistake of eating quite a bit off camera already, but it's really good. Not that pretty, not that attractive. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you make this pot pie recipe, please show me. Snap the photo and tag us at food.period and use the hashtag mykitchensink and I'll be waiting, so you better do it. Please come back next week to watch the final installment of our Fall Feast special. This is really good. Next week is a dessert. Hint, it's sweet, it's creamy. So come back and don't miss it. Bye.